Today we're going to talk about something a lot of people deal with but don't always know how to handle. Blepharitis. It's an eye condition that can cause irritation, redness, and discomfort along the eyelids. If you're struggling with itching, crusting, or general irritation around your eyes from blepharitis, don't worry, you're not alone. Stick around because I'll walk you through a simple 5-step method for blepharitis. And real quick, guys, it would mean the world to me if you hit the thumbs up button down below. And if you like this type of content, definitely consider subscribing for new weekly videos. Now, I already made a video about face mites that I highly encourage you to watch next because it looks at the connection between face mites and symptoms of blepharitis. First, let's start by understanding exactly what blepharitis is. Blepharitis is an inflammation of the eyelids, usually around the base of your eyelashes. It could cause symptoms like redness, itching, burning, grittiness, and even flaky skin or crust forming on your eyelids. Sounds uncomfortable, right? But don't worry, it's more common than you think and is usually manageable with the right approach. There are two types of blepharitis. You got anterior blepharitis. This affects the outside of the eyelid where your lashes are and is often caused by bacteria or dandruff. Some bacterial strains produce the enzyme lipase, which breaks down the lipid components of the tear film, leading to the production of free fatty acids, which can worsen the inflammation. The anterior type is more common in those who also have seborrheic dermatitis. Then there is posterior blepharitis. This type affects the inner part of the eyelid and is linked to issues with the oil glands in the eyelids called the meibomian gland, which can lead to dry eyes and is linked to meibomian gland dysfunction, where the glands oversecrete an oily substance, leading to clogging and engorgement, and is more common in those who also have rosacea and those that have recurrent styes. Chances are, if you get recurring styes, you may also have experienced blepharitis as well. But here's the thing, guys. Both the anterior and posterior forms of blepharitis can be associated with both Demodex folliculorum and Demodex brevis infestations, which are the face mites we talked about in this video. And both share a lot of the same symptoms. When these mites cause infestation, you get local irritation in the eye region because of their waste products, which cause mechanical obstruction of the follicles themselves. And your tissues typically will go through what's called hyperkeratinization and perifollicular inflammation, which leads to all the redness and crusting you're seeing. And sometimes that sensation of a foreign body in the eye. So that kind of explains what's happening. So what do you do? The first is to get a proper diagnosis so your doctor can rule out any other similar condition so we can identify that it actually is blepharitis. And once we do that first, the first place to start is to cleanse and disinfect the eyelids. Proper eyelid hygiene is critical to controlling blepharitis and preventing flare-ups. So start with a warm compress. Simply soak a clean cloth in warm water, wring it out, and gently place it over your closed eyelids for about 5 to 10 minutes. This helps loosen up any debris, oil, or crust that's built up on the eyelids. Step two is, after the compress, use a lid scrub or an eyelid wipe to gently cleanse the base of your lashes. The Ocusoft Lid Scrubs, which I left below for you as an affiliate, do an amazing job at this. You can also use over-the-counter products like blepharitis wipes that contain green tea and tea tree oil, which I linked for you below as well. These will also help destroy face mites, and you want to use them for about 6 weeks. Step three is, if you have posterior blepharitis, you could also do this for anterior, but after you have cleansed the eyes, you're going to want to make sure your hands are clean and start gently massaging the eyelid margin, which is this area here, to express all the oils from the meibomian glands. You want to do this with a fingertip in small circular motions. The pressure applied during the massage really does help to dislodge any hardened oils or mucus that may be blocking the glands, guys. And also, meibomian gland massage helps improve the quality of your tears, because if the oil produced by these glands is thickened or clogged, it can cause the tear film to be unstable, leading to dryness and grittiness in the eyes themselves. So doing this will keep the surface of the eye lubricated for longer too. Step four, you're going to need to address the inflammation, right? Blepharitis is an inflammatory condition, so reducing inflammation is key to managing symptoms and preventing future flare-ups. This can be done with either prescription medication or over-the-counter remedies. For mild cases, you might start with the artificial tears or lubricating eye drops to soothe the irritation and hydrate the eyes. For more severe cases, your doctor may recommend topical antibiotics or steroid eye drops to reduce inflammation and bacteria on the eyelids. Usually, they'll prescribe you a cream such as Basitre acetracin or erythromycin to be applied to the lid margin for 2 to 8 weeks. But on the step where we're focusing on the inflammation, you have to do your very best not to touch, rub, or aggressively wipe the affected eyes, which can make the inflammation worse. It's also important on this step to manage both rosacea and seborrheic dermatitis if you also concurrently have those conditions going on, because resolving them can also help speed up the time recovering from blepharitis itself. There are other subtle things that we do on an everyday basis that can make inflammation worse in this area, such as heavy makeup use and digital eye strain by staring at your devices, even just for as little as 2 hours for some folks. And lastly, guys, step 5 is all about consistency and lifestyle adjustments. Blepharitis can be a chronic condition, meaning that managing it will require regular upkeep. Here are a few tips for staying on top of it. So, regular eyelid hygiene, like we mentioned, make it a habit to clean your eyelids every day, even if you're feeling better, to avoid flare-ups. Avoid makeup or eye products that could irritate the eyes, mascara, eyeliner, and eyeshadow while you're actively managing the blepharitis itself. Once it's gone, you could go back to wearing them. Take breaks from screen time. You want to make sure you take breaks and blink often. And lastly, one tip that so many people underestimate, and we talk about a lot on this channel, is to change your pillowcase frequently. At least twice a week, guys. An unwashed pillowcase can accumulate approximately 3 million bacteria per square inch after just 1 week on your pillow. So think about that, guys. This means about 17,000 times more bacteria than the average toilet seat. And keep in mind, guys, if your blepharitis persists or worsens despite these steps that I've provided you, you want to see an eye care professional. An eye doctor or ophthalmologist can provide a more personalized treatment plan. They can prescribe stronger medicines or perform an in-office procedure like the meibomian gland expression, which involves manually releasing blockages in the glands. In some cases, they can use thermal pulsation therapy, such as the LipiFlow device, which applies heat to both the anterior and posterior surfaces of the eyelids, which can help remove debris and crusting from the meibomian glands. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys now. What has helped your blepharitis? Do you have any tips and tricks that you know that has worked? Leave them in the comments below. And until then, guys, watch the video I made on face mites, and I'll see you on the next one.